This is what we're going to be reviewing today. Yeah. There's a reason why I choose this for review. And the reason is just because of people that are starting out, you know, podcasting or just want to do audio recording or things like that. So we're going to open this up. Let's see what is inside, okay? Now we have some documentation. A little bit flimsy. What's this? I don't know what's that. Then we have two batteries, another thing. I think that's all about it. When it comes to the design, everything is not bad, but this thing look good, but the build quality is flimsy. I think that is why Zoom is trying to save money for you to get this device for the price they're selling it now. Okay, so I'll give it to them for that. You will break it if you drop it. Maybe one or twice is okay. The smell is not bad. This thing smell okay. And it's using AA battery. So I'm going to power it with two AA batteries. Close it up. This is actually built for podcasts, okay? If you want this, it's going to be for podcast. So you have four inputs and four dedicated preamp for each of the inputs. And right here, you have a switch pad that will provide a phantom power. If you're using a phantom power microphone, a microphone that require power, then you can switch to it and that will give you phantom power. And that applicable to all the input or channel. But the channel 1 and 2, they have just two switches, inside a microphone. It's either dynamic microphone or a condenser microphone. But if you look at the 3 and 4, you have more option. In 3 and 4, you can either use dynamic microphone or you can use condenser microphone or you can use your phone. And channel 4 also can take input from microphone, which is condenser, dynamic, or you can use that a USB to play back. If you're playing something from your computer, you can easily route it here, or you can actually route your phone, which means you can receive two phone calls at the same time using channel 3 and channel 4. Or you can use channel 3 to receive one phone call, channel 4 to play music back from your computer and record it. Or you can just put Skype or whatever you want to do, you can put it on channel 4. Or maybe Zoom meeting, anything on channel 4, you can still get recording in. So which means you can select either of three options between in channel 3 and channel 4, okay? And that's about that. And each of the channel has a mute button. I will call this one on here button, but it's like a mute button. Once you press it, it mutes the channel. On this black section, we have four pads. This pad actually have a preloaded jingle on it, okay? There's a preloaded jingle on it. This is where you turn it on at this side. That's the power button, okay? And beside the power button, you have these two inputs. One, you can use your phone. That is, if you plug your phone headphone here, it will automatically use channel 3, okay? And you can buy an adapter for Bluetooth. You can get that from Zoom. If you want to use a Bluetooth at all, just like you want to connect your phone using Bluetooth, then you can use this. It's an adapter you will buy from Zoom. It's not included, but you can buy it if you want it. So let's press the power now and turn it on. So now it's coming on. When you open the side right here, it's taking one SD card. And at this side, you have the DC input, and that is USB-C. And the other side here, you have your, if you want to use this thing as audio interface, you can easily use it as audio interface, okay? And this is the volume control. So this volume control all the four parts, okay? Whatever volume you set it is gonna be the same volume for all the four parts, all right? So after that, you have the screen where you have to do your settings, whatever you need to do. Then you have your menu button right here. You have play button, stop button, and record button. And down here is where you have your headphone output. So when you plug your headphone, you have four headphones, separate headphones. So each of your guests or co-hosts to have their own separate headphone, and they have their volume control of the headphone individual. One main function that makes this thing stand out from other little devices that are recording audio is the mix minus. Okay, the mix minus is a key if you are doing podcasting and you're going to be receiving phone call, or you're going to be doing Skype call or anything of such. You will need mix minus. Even before we have devices like this that have mix minus built in, there's a way around it, but you know, it's a little bit cumbersome to do if you don't know your way around audio routing. Okay, so it could be a little bit challenging for a new beginner, but for this devices coming out now, it's like a win-win for everybody because you don't have to go through that much of headache. For the price, $199, you can't go wrong for what you will get on this. You lose nothing much if you go with this. If podcasting is all you do and you not have more than maybe one or two, three guests, that's cool, because this can take four microphones initially. Can take four microphones, and you will enjoy it if you're just starting out. You don't lose much if you're just starting out. Okay, and I'm going to tell you right now, this is a really good device for podcasting. You lose nothing much if you choose this instead of the L8 or the PodTrack 8 or the Rodecaster. Okay, just because you're starting out. But at long run, if you want to upgrade, fine. But this way, get the job done if you're doing a podcast. Alright? But my take on this is that if you take care of this very well, I think it will last you a long time. I can guarantee that it will last you a long time if you keep it very well. But all I'm going to say is, if you do feed recording, I will still say that the H6 is better. If you're recording directly on the SD card, it's going to record all four channels separately so that you can edit them later individually. It's going to record the part also so that if you want to edit them later. At the same time, it's going to record everything, so it's like you're getting the mix of everything and a separate of each channel. I don't know if that is clear enough. It's like you're getting a quick mix immediately right out of the PodTrack 4. But if you're using this as an audio interface going into your computer, it's not going to record individual input separate. It's going to record everything as a mix on your computer. If you are using that audio interface, if you are recording directly going to your computer, it will only record everything in stereo mix on your computer. But at the same time, you can record on the SD card and record on your computer as a backup. You will get all this recorded separately. You will have a stereo mix, and at the same time, you have a stereo mix on your computer. Okay? But it's not going to give you the option to record individual channel on your computer. Just know that, okay? If you want to save money, right? You can save money starting out your podcast. So, this is a welcome idea. It's a very good one. It's portable enough to travel with, and you can actually use it in your studio if you want to start out your podcast. Like I said, if you're just starting out your podcast, you're a little low on budget, you're going to need your microphone, you're going to need your mic stand, you know, a lot of things you're going to put in place to start your podcast, I would say this is not a bad idea to start with. If you're going to start your podcast now, this is not a bad idea to start with. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and that will be my time on the PodTrack 4. Until next time that you're going to see me again, stay blessed.